Well, what would be the best advice that you guys can give to the audience out there when they want to give it a try to a business, you know, for first time as a business owners? Maybe both of you can help to answer, or maybe I even can answer first.
What advice, in terms of any specific, like, terms, or it's just business in general?
Yeah, in terms of finances, let's say for finances.
I think learn on your balance sheet, income statement, cash flow statement. Make sure you have money. Always saved up for a rainy day. Don't go and spend. There are some months that you will earn a lot of money, five figures, six figures, whatever. But don't go and spend the money and buy a nice car. Because car is a liability. Understand what is asset, what is liability. Make sure if you know your why, don't go into business for quick money. So make sure you understand money, how money works, and I think it can help you run a business better or lead a business better. Yeah, especially like MCO during this season, this year, a lot of people couldn't predict cash flow. That is why they had to close down, because there are a lot of uncertainty. There's no clarity of the future. So when you don't have clarity of the future, what can you do is that you have to, money is the one that would sustain, like it will just prolong the whatever damage until you find something that can, can fix that problem.
Mm.
Yeah. So make sure you have cash in hand. Otherwise, you borrow from Maybank lah.
Why not?
Yeah, good for the bank as well.
Yeah, good. One of the good marketing anyway. You can borrow from Maybank. We have Maybank no issue on that.
Maybank loans is good.
All right. Okay. All right. We have come to a certain part where we already understand the sustaining on the business, managing the business, right? So I would love to ask these questions to Irfan, right? So help us to understand further, or help us to understand better, what is a zero cost marketing, Irfan?
Okay, that's a good question actually. For me, zero cost marketing nowadays is the internet. There are so many platforms for you to promote your business for free. It is hard to believe actually. Macam tak percaya juga how much people can generate money just by using a free platform such as Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, WhatsApp and many other social medias lah. So you just need to know how and the right techniques to use it. And of course, in an early stage, you need to spend some money first to get an audience. Okay, apart from friends and relatives to promote your business, you can do a paid review to gain some audience first. Please remember in business, talking as a marketing guy, in business, the more money you'll be make, in business, the more money that you spend on marketing, the more money that you'll be make. Okay, don't do business if you are afraid to throw away some money. Business just for them who are willing to take the risk and gamble, as long as you will believe in what you are doing. But again, make sure to do it with the right technique. So after you dah ada platforms, you dah ada some audience and some followers, and then the zero cost marketing will come after that. Once you get the audience, okay, you can automatically gain sales just by sharing content through your social medias. Okay. And yeah, of course, do some giveaway. Celebrate your early fans, create some value to your products, give them discount codes to their next purchase. As an example, simple free gift, repost those who tag you and like their comments, something like this. All these little things can be called as zero marketing for me, where it will slowly gain trust to your existing customer, existing audience, and also grow your followers little by little. Then all you need is just consistency on doing it. That is how crazy and easier online business is once you get the you know how the technique is.
True. So basically, it's like more like if we provide a good service or product, then people will start to spread the words. You know, I think that is part of the zero marketing, if not mistaken.
Yes,
la,
correct.
Right? Okay. All right. So basically, we already have some insight on the business, in managing our business, in sustaining the business as well. So I think this will be my last questions to both of you. And also, thanks Ivan and Irfan for that very insightful session just now. And I hope from what we've discussed during this talk show would definitely encourage our audience here today to pursue their dreams about building their own business empire someday, right? Well, hello everyone. As the title from the video suggests, welcome to Budgeting and Become Cashless. My name is Paul and I will be your moderator for this session. So guys, for your information, this will be the last talk show for M-Campus. Today, I am joined by two special guests here on set to give their advice on and opinions regarding our topic for today. Joining me is Go Hao Kiam and Hani. Thank you for dropping by. I'm sure our audience would like to get to... I think I got it wrong. So, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our panels to introduce themselves. So, guys, would you mind to introduce yourself?
I'll go first.
Yes.
Go. Hello, hi. My name is Hao Kiam, or you can call me HK. So, I am the head of marketing and user experience from Maybank's digital banking team.
Okay.
Over to you, honey.
All right, thanks. First of all, I wanted to say thanks, everyone, for having me here today. Thanks, Paul. Thanks to the organizer. I'm Hani Nazrina. I'm actually in the same team with HK, doing marketing at Zach. So this is actually my third year with Maybank as a marketer. But before I joined Maybank, I was actually a freelancer, which I do acting for a few years. So. Yeah, it's a big transition of job to me.
I'm pretty sure there's a lot of people out there know you, Hani.
Yeah.
I mean,
It's a leap. Right, okay, anyway, thanks, Hani and Hao Kiam. Now that we've gotten familiar with our speakers, let's move on, all right? So, as pretty much all of us aware that budgeting is one of the most important financial habits that you can adopt. But if you never live on a budget or haven't experienced all the benefits that budgeting has to offer, it's easy to wonder why it's such a prominent aspect of personal finance. So, why is budgeting important? It helps you to control your spending, track your expenses, and save more money. Additionally, budgeting can help you make better financial decisions, prepare for emergencies, get out of debt, and stay focused on your long-term financial goals. So, Hani, and what do you think? Here, Pyrus. Pyrus have come up with a clever budgeting tricks. So what are your thoughts on this?
So are we gonna show any video? Okay.
Very famous budgeting method known as the 50-30-20 budgeting rule. Number one, spend 50% of your income towards your needs, such as your car payment, your bills, your mortgages, your groceries. Number two, spend 20% of your income towards the things that you wanted. For example, that movie night, that date night, or maybe that vacation or that new gadget. Number three, spend the remaining 20% towards your savings and investment.
So, before we start, what do you think? I mentioned earlier, right? So, yeah, Fyrus has shared some clever budgeting tricks. So, what are your thoughts on this, Hani and HK?
I think it's a very, a basic rule for those who are starting to budget right now because it's 50, 30, 20. Before this, to be honest, I don't know. Apa ni 50, 30, 20? Until, at a certain pace, I understand what is it budgeting about, but the way that Fyrus explained just now, it's super simple. It's very easy to understand. And one thing that I would like to emphasize, the platform that he's using there, which is TikTok, targeting the youth segment, because we know that nowadays, this budgeting is super important for youth, or we call it millennials.
Right. So, HK, maybe you would like to add up what Hani have said?
Yeah, I think Fyrus is probably going to be a celebrity. Yeah, because he's going to get popular because...
job like this.
I think that's probably the first ever financial management video that will be on TikTok.
TikTok,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's pretty like, what we can see, pretty like out of norms. even financial institutions have their own TikToks, you know, by and managing by our own very own bankers. You know, okay. I think I can give a good compliment to Fairoz, for your TikToks. Now, okay, guys, before we start this session, just like our previous talk show sessions, we will also give out a special prize. What are we possibly giving out this time? Does a smartphone sound good to you? Only one lucky participant will stand the chance to win this smartphone. So, join our question by the end of this talk show. Who knows? You might be the lucky owner of a new phone. Now, ladies and gentlemen, audience out there, without further ado, let's start. So, okay. Honey and HK, I do have some questions that have been, not to say troubling lah, eh? Dia macam berlega-lega di fikiran I sikit. Kan? So, as I first start lah untuk buat budgeting ni kan, what are the measures or what should we take into considerations, take into account of before starting our budgeting journey ni?
Okay,
I'll start. I go first. Siapa-siapa boleh, tak apa. It's open.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. So first, what I foresee, before you start budget, you need to decide, you need to identify why do you want to budget? Why do you want to do budgeting? Because people tend to do something when they have a purpose or a reason to do, like an objective lah. Like macam, aku nak study sebab esok aku exam aku nak dapat A, something like that. So it's the same thing. Why I want to budget? Because I want to buy a house, for example. I want to get married, for example. And then next, you need to rate the importance of the budget goals. Because of course, like, macam I nak everything at the same time, you know, macam like nak marry at the same time, nak beli rumah at the same time, nak dapat kereta at the same time. Yeah, so, like macam tamah, you know. So it's something that you need to rate the importance. Which one do you want to achieve first? So that it's, because once you decide, once you prioritize and set everything, the importance of everything that you want to get, so it's very proper, and then you can manage your money wisely. And then next, you need to set a time limit. This is very important that I would like to emphasize, because it sets you to be someone that is disciplined. For example, when you set a time limit for you to achieve something, let's say I want to buy a house by next year, right? So I need to set money monthly. So every month I need to save money. For example, like, it depends lah how much do you want to save for how long. And you need to set the period by when do I need to achieve this kind of amount. Because let's say you didn't set a limit of time or you didn't set any period of timing, you tend to be like, macam, alah tak apalah, tak nak lah save next month lah. You know, dia macam like, this is very important for you to discipline yourself. Yeah.
HK, can I say like more to like prioritizing? Boleh tak kita cakap macam tu? Like prioritizing your budget tu semua?
Yes, yes,
okay, like 50-30-20 tu. I don't even know about 50-30-20 tu macam ni cakap tadi kan. So yes, HK, we would love to hear from you.
Actually, I cannot agree more with what Hani just said about the savings part. So that is extremely, extremely important. Because whatever we want, whether, you know, it's a new PS5 or whether, you know, saving for a house or a car, right? I think all these, instead of spending impulsively, we should save towards it. So that's really very important. And I think now, with budgeting, right, what we should take into account when we budget is definitely the money that we have. So usually these are like income or, for example, pocket money,
right,
or, for example, side income. Right, your salary, something like that. So money that you get in, what we should do is definitely to put aside for savings first. Save what you need to, whether it's for, you know, like for example, just now I mentioned, right, for down payment of your car or for your shopping and so forth. Put those aside first, and then the money that you have left, use it for your spending. Yeah, I think a lot of us actually, or I made a mistake before as well when I first started working, right, which is didn't know how to budget. So I get my salary, I spend first.
It happens to everyone.
Right? I spend first. And then at the end of the day, at the end of the month, usually I didn't have much left. So what I have learned the hard way is flip it around, do the savings first, prioritize those because those are really the things that you want. Then only you spend accordingly.
Yeah. I see. So, okay, guys, having said on those points that you mentioned just now, right, do you think it's a must for you to have a budget for their own? I mean, like, they can plan their budgeting. So, you think it's a good startup for you in terms of budgeting?
I would say it definitely is. because, you know, as a youth, or we call it millennials, okay? It's a very challenging for us because I'm a millennials too. So it's a very challenging, you know, because we tend to like macam being so obsessed towards social media. So we tend to follow the trend. We want to keep on updated. So we spend a lot because we want to keep updated. So the thing here is what I noticed in this challenging situation, you need to be disciplined to save money because it's very important. Why? Because it can minimize your financial burden in the future. For example, you won't know what's going to happen to you, like, you know, like emergencies, suddenly kereta rosak ke anything, unexpected job loss. We'll never know because of this, you know, the current situation really affected nowadays. And then the other thing that I realized, because dulu I sangat boros, I'm sorry to say this, I don't know the 50, 30, 20. But when I start learning to do savings, I understand that this is very important in long-term benefits. For example, you will demonstrate a positive personality of which you know how to manage your own money. For example, you know how much are you going to do savings on that month? How much are you going to deposit? How much is your commitment? So it's like macam in a long-term process, you dah tahu what you're going to do. It's either home ownership, you dah ada that kind of personality. I'm a very committed person, disciplined, I can do this. You know, like personality lah.
Well, that's some good advice. Yeah, it is a good advice.
Because I'm so boros.
used to be honest, I am too boros also. You know, it happens to everyone. No, the first year I started as a women banker, I like HK, I spent all my money. Every single month I spent all money, spend, you know, like a rich people spending the money. But now I know the importance of budgeting and I know the importance of having some backup financials. Mm-hmm. It's very, very important. So okay, Honey has raised her points towards this budgeting. So let's hear from HK, yeah?
Okay, I think, again, I agree with Honey. I think the saving part, right? Again, you know, that's super important. And since you asked, Paul, you asked about youth, right? What I want to highlight is, you know, it is especially important to start when we are young.
Correct.
Because when you have savings, there is the power of compounding. Meaning you save aside, let's say if you put it into a fixed deposit account or we put it aside for investment, right? So we earn interest. So the interest will be added to the principal and then you earn more interest and so on. So looking at the power of compounding interest, right? Basically, for youth, there are many, many, many years for you to keep snowballing your savings, your interest. And basically, after a number of years, you basically will get to save a small fortune. So I think that is very important in terms of saving diligently. And number two is, of course, also to be debt-free, right? I think when you budget, you very likely you'll be debt-free. And I think being debt-free is without that financial stress, right? You're not stressed about like, oh, I'm overspending this month. So next month, I'll be having less money to spend. I think, you know, to go through that kind of stress, actually, it can be quite bothersome.
Yes.
So, okay, if I may, would it be considered like if we practice this budgeting, right? So, we will tend to see a remarkable result at the end in terms of like your financial goals, ke, financial planning, ke, apa yang you nak, ke, like that?
I think so, actually. It will definitely make a difference. So, if we don't budget, if we spend according to how we feel like, so that is, you know, We can say, as you know, I don't consider that much. I will spend whenever I want to. So that's a bit impulsive, right? And the danger of it is that, you know, you spend the money that you probably may not have yet. You know, like for example, swiping a credit card. So you're spending money.
I love doing that.
So you're spending money in the future, right? So you need to pay the debt at one point. Right. So that's number one. And number two is also, you may overspend and you may not have enough money for your necessities, for example, for your food or for your groceries for the rest of the month. And that can be quite stressful as well. So I think with budgeting, it avoids situations like this. So it makes us feel, perhaps, you know, a bit more organized in terms of how we spend. And it avoids situation whereby, you know, we will end up not having enough money or we end up being in debt. Yeah, so I think budgeting definitely will avoid situation like that.
All right, it is. I believe so. It will happen. I believe so. Well, I'm going to practice budgeting as well. You know that tour, which you can.
No, to be honest,
it's never too late.
True,
too late
true. In fact, I've started to practice the 50-30-20 just recently.
after seeing Fairuz's video. Yeah.
Because time is getting tough, yeah? Yeah. Time is getting tough, so you need to have a plan in terms of your financial. So, okay, we already spoken on this, the 50-30-20, the planning, you know, how you going to sort things out with your salary, all that. So, I would love to hear from both of you, is there any, methods of in terms of budgeting? So, would you like to share with us, is there any methods that is very successful?
Maybe I can share first personally how I do it. So actually the rules that Fairuz
Before you go for that, this is for first timers,
Okay. Yeah, so then I need to recall that after the period when I didn't budget and when I first started budgeting, I still use the same rule. But I kind of tweaked it a little bit to suit myself. So 50-30-20 was the rule that I started with also. And that was a good start because, you know, what I did was I took my salary and then I apportioned it accordingly. So 50% to my needs, 30% to my wants, and then 20% to the savings, right? But when I first started doing it, of course, you know, I wasn't very disciplined. So my 30% of savings... So, you know, my 30% of the savings sometimes will go into the wants. Right? Very silently it will go into that.
Jumping here and there.
Yeah, correct. So, so what happened was then, you know, it was a bit inconsistent, right?
True.
Some month I save more, some month I save less, or some month I didn't save.
True enough.
Yeah, so then what happened was I was reading and then I was also, you know, trying different methods. And what worked for me today is actually I take the same rule, I flip it around. I tabale it. So basically, instead of 50-30-20, I start with 20 first. When I get my salary, when I get my income, I put aside the 20. So basically, I make sure that I save first, you know, and I make sure that, you know, I plan ahead also in terms of what I want to save for. It could be buying something for my wife. It could be spending for something that I like, my hobbies, for example, right? But I save towards it. So I always save first and then only I take the money that that I have left and then spend it accordingly. Yeah. So basically, my way of doing it is I take the 50-30-20 and flip it around.
I see.
Yeah. So there is also another method which is called envelope system.
Oh, I never heard of it.
Yeah.
So you have to share.
Yeah, no, sure.
Interesting. Yeah, very interesting. No, so that's why envelope pula sekarang ni.
So this was something that I came across which I felt, you know, it was quite interesting. So that's why I would like to share a bit more about envelope system. So literally, the reason why it's called envelope system is because you take your money in cash form, it's in real cash, and then you take a bunch of envelopes, right? And then you label your envelope based on your spending category. Like for example, your food ke, your bubble tea ke, your
Starbucks.
Yeah, your Starbucks or your cafe lunch, for example, right?
This is manual, is it?
Yeah. So it's
this is more like macam mak kita, bapak kita dulu-dulu tau. Macam letak duit berbantal.
Ikat-ikat ketan.
It is like that. So I think it's a very traditional way. But the good thing behind it is, okay, so you have all this category, you label all your envelope, right? Then you put the money, you put the cash accordingly. So that means food, I plan to spend, for example, 200 ringgit, right? So you masukkan the 200 ringgit notes into the envelope. And then plus the other envelope also accordingly. Okay, so then every time you spend, you can only take the money from the envelope.
I see.
Yeah. So, what happens is then...
Cannot cut out other envelope.
You cannot. Okay. So, you have to be disciplined. You cannot cut out other envelope and...
My.
I don't think Paul can do
that. Definitely. Because the envelope is different of my eyes.
So, that's why the envelope system, it requires us to be very disciplined. Right?
Yeah.
You take the... One thing is you cannot touch other envelope. Let's say if you're going for, like, I'm going to go buy groceries, right? You can only touch the grocery envelope. You cannot touch other envelope. Even if the money runs out already in your grocery envelope. Say, let's say, last week I decided to indulge, right? I buy more ice cream. So this week I got not much left.
Okay.
So basically, you just have to spend whatever that's left there, and then you buy whatever you can afford.
Yeah.
So basically, it trains us to be a bit more disciplined. It makes us think a bit more like, oh, I have this much money left. Okay, how should I spend it? How should I prioritize and deprioritizing? Yeah. So this is another method that I came across, which I felt basically it's very good because it trains us to be disciplined.
Right.
But realistically speaking, I think nowadays, right, because there's credit card, because you know there's e-wallet as well, right? We're all using other form of spending. So this method, if you're not using fully cash, sometimes it can be a bit inconvenient.
Physical kind.
I see. So I think I believe Honey have a different
why you always pandang I macam tu?
Yeah, because why you are millennial.
Okay, because like I said just now kan I tak tahu apa benda 50-30-20 ni. So what, so I understand that different rule have, there is no right or wrong of what kind of method you are using as long as it's best fit your goals and your needs. So I understand that the common is 50-30-20, which Honey doesn't know, never follow. So what I did is I do the automatic-based budget. Automatic-based budget ni maksudnya you set everything auto-pay. For example, your savings, you already set your account. Auto-pay, auto-debit savings. And then your loan, for example, your charity bills, your rental. And then the remaining balance baru then you use. So this is how I use it, because I already put aside the savings account because I know that every month, okay, ni dah akan deduct. So I tak payah kacau like pening kepala, oh, how much do I want to save for this month? So it's already auto set. And then the remaining baru I set aside whether this month I want to go shopping ke, I want to do self-treat a bit like mani-pedi ke. So let's say I dah go shopping this month. So next month, maybe I can do something else like spa or anything. So because well, it's not like you need to limit all your fun things.
Correct.
You know?
Yes.
Actually, that's very important. I think it's about having the balance.
Correct.
Right. We need to enjoy ourselves also.
Yeah. Because we are working so hard, so we deserve a little treatment for ourselves. So, okay, that's a very insightful coming from both of them, HK and Honey. So, okay, nowadays, can Honey and HK, I've been receiving a lot of questions, though, in terms of, like, especially during these tough times where we are living in as a new norms and kita pun ada pandemic situation. Ada orang yang bertanya, what if I don't get paid full? Okay, ataupun dia punya income fluctuates. You know, how do they do budgeting? You know, so unlike like a young person working with a stable organization, they will get paid in full.
Yeah.
Tapi ada yang affected, those kind of person yang dia punya salary kena cut, you know, and then salary dia bukan yang based on yang fixed salary. So how can they manage in terms of budgeting?
Okay, this is actually very interesting because I've been experienced this because I was a freelancer before. So actually, this is very common scenario for people who are self-employed, freelancer, or maybe working for commission. So based on my previous experience, it's very, very challenging. I was like, macam, I cannot expect what kind of job or what income am I getting for the following month, you know? Like, macam, it's very unpredictable. So I was like, there is even 1 month, satu tu I macam like, for 2 months actually, I was like, macam, I have no project, I have no job, what am I going to do? Luckily, I have savings. So this kind of experience really macam like very impactful to my life, which I learned a few things. One of it are you need to identify your baseline, your commitments and your earnings, which means whether your commitments is actually greater or less than your earnings. So let's say you expand, expense more, meaning for your rental ke, your shopping or anything, you need to ensure that you need to cut down this thing to maintain that kind of monthly spending. Because if not, it's like macam you earn sikit but you spend a lot, which is very not healthy. So yeah, so the first thing is you need to identify your baseline. Is your commitments and your earnings balanced? It's not supposed to be balanced lah, which means your earning kena lagi banyak pada what's your expenditure. And then second, you need to like set up a separate bank account, like an emergency fund. So this is very, very important because what I've experienced last time, kan, it's like macam you need to ensure this having a, this emergency fund or savings, the extra savings account that you're having can suffice or can like mampu help you for the following 3 months. Let's say you have nothing to do, like macam you have no income masuk or anything. So this is one of the most important thing. And also you need to live your life with the lowest monthly income that you'll be getting. So contohnya macam like, because you know, we tend to macam like, oh, okay, minggu depan, bulan depan aku dapat projek banyak ni, okay, aku lah, aku dah boleh spend lah. So this kind of thing, yes, understand lah, semua orang akan happy kan, but at the same time, you need to remember that the following month, will you be getting the same? So it's like you need to always live the lowest monthly income that you already received.
Understand. Yeah. So basically macam contohlah, giving the example macam I kalau nak ambil into the into taking that into consideration, contoh I pergi shopping, pergi supermarket,
yeah,
kan, I kata okay I nak beli Maggi je, and tiba-tiba macam barang aku pada satu troli.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It's okay for you to budget lowers, but maybe the following month you can budget up a bit, sikit, yeah. So macam like self treat, but it's you always need to maintain, not suddenly like macam nak beli Maggi satu troli tu tak boleh lah. At least 3 Maggi ke okay lah,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah, itulah kadang-kadang kita ni we have the impulsive kind of behavior tau, honey. So bila kita okay we budget, kita dah budget dah, okay aku nak spend RM50 je kat supermarket hari ni. Tapi bila sampai di supermarket dan you tend to buy like Maggi, apa minyak masak, semua benda lah you beli. You budget RM50 je tapi you are spending more than what you're budgeting. Itulah yang kadang-kadang happen kan, betul HK?
Yeah. So that happened to me also. I think personal experience, right? So and also definitely need to avoid going for grocery shopping when we are hungry. Because we end up buying a lot of things that actually we don't need.
Yeah,
right? Junk food. So actually my wife and I, we started doing this about a couple of months ago, because you know nowadays we're working from home, right? So we tend to cook more at home. So okay, in the beginning, right, what we did was we went to grocery shopping, so we just freestyle lah. Okay, I see this, I feel like buying, so I take. So you know, like okay, then we
freestyle.
Yeah, so we have a correct.
You got a list, you mean?
So that was before we had the list.
Nowadays, this is the first time I heard people saying freestyle was shopping.
Yeah. So nowadays when we have a list, okay, so started about 1 month plus ago, right? We started having a clear shopping list before we go for grocery shopping every week. And I would say, I would proudly say that the grocery bill actually dropped by more than 30%.
Oh.
It's about being disciplined, it's about planning ahead. That does make a difference.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe I can talk to HK, okay? I'm not going to share with you guys.
I will share with you my topic.
All right, now guys, since that we have touched on your preferred budget method, I think I would like to find the gist of it, like, of doing so. So my biggest question would be like, do you even track your expenses?
Maybe I take that question first. Actually, I do. I don't track it to the decimal point, and I don't track it to the extent that, you know, I look at how much money I have on a daily basis. But the very important part is knowing where my financial situation is. That means, you know, to put it simply, right, is making sure I know how much money I have, right? So, okay, just to share a bit of, you know, how I manage my budget and my expenses on a monthly basis, right? Okay. So, when I get my salary, basically, okay, as I mentioned earlier, I put into savings first, right? Okay, then after that, I will take a sum of money, and then these basically will be considered as my daily expenses for the month, right? And then the rest of it, I will put it as rainy days or emergency fund in a separate account. Okay, so I will spend then based on this amount of money that I have allocated aside. So again, you know, what it makes sure is I have done the more important thing part, the emergency fund and also the savings. So I have this money left, which I know if I spend all this money, I will not go beyond my means. Yeah. So as a start, I already know that, you know, most likely I won't go over budget, right? But nowadays, there's this thing called credit card, right? So I use credit card. I use credit card for the benefits, right?